Hello, I'm Eddy Butler and welcome to the next edition of the Butler blog.
My name's Julian Lippert. I'm an Epping Forest District Councillor representing Pat Rosterwald in Waltham Abbey for the For Britain Party.
On this rainy day in July, we're outside a pub or a hotel called the Bell Hotel, which is a local landmark. This, what we're standing on, is called Bell Common. The Bell is a 16th century coaching inn. It's 3-star rated. It's got a bar in there called the Nirvana Lounge and Bar. It's quite a posh establishment.
Yeah, as Eddie was saying, this hotel, it's not just a hotel, it's an integral part of our local heritage here in Epping Forest. But the bad news, the hotel is now currently being used to house asylum seekers, stroke illegal immigrants, people who have no business in this country, have all travelled across several perfectly safe countries in order to come here and exploit our benefit system. And of course, this is not welcome. It's a security risk to local people. We've already seen what's happened this year. Similar incident in Glasgow, an asylum seeker in a hotel went on a stabbing rampage. A recent incident in Reading, 3 young British men were stabbed to death by another asylum seeker. And perhaps worst of all, we saw what happened in Bolton. 7-year-old Emily Jones, she had her throat slit on Mother's Day by another uninvited guest onto our shores. And this is not acceptable. People of Epping Forest, people of Epping in particular, should be angry about this, and most important of all, they should stop voting for the politicians who are responsible for it.
Yes, because they've imported a potentially deadly risk right into the heart of our community,
haven't they? Absolutely. Epping's a lovely place to live, and well, we for one would certainly like to keep it that way.
We're going to have a closer look now at the hotel, see what's actually going on there. According to the local neighbourhood watch, there's been a big increase in pickpocketing in Epping lately, and in the staff in Tesco's tells us there's been a big increase in shoplifting as well. We've moved down to Loughton now, and over the road there is the Loughton Club. The Loughton Club is being used as a hub for a local group called Three Food For You. That's Three Food For You. Which has been set up to provide free food for local people who are on hard times during this hard, difficult situation that the country's facing. Which is a very laudable thing to do, and it makes people avoid having to use food banks, which make people jump through hoops in order to get hoops and bring various proofs. So it's a free scheme, very laudable, isn't it?
Absolutely. And ordinarily, this very worthy local enterprise is something we'd obviously wholeheartedly support, but unfortunately there is another side to it, because much of the food that's been intended for use by local people who are falling on hard times is now being diverted to the hotel in Epping, which is currently being used to house asylum seekers stroke illegal immigrants, i.e. people who've traversed many, many perfectly safe countries to exploit our benefit system. And it's being used to feed them instead. People that get, they get fed three times anyway. So this is just not acceptable.
Yeah, the hotel, the Bell, where we were just at, gives them three meals a day, gives them free Wi-Fi, gives them all their toiletries, and yet this charity, this local group, are diverting foods away from the mouths of our people to these illegal immigrants who get well fed anyway.
That's right, we need to support our local people first. People are struggling in this country, we need to support them first.
And this building is quite interesting in itself as far as we're concerned.
Absolutely, yeah, because before it changed owners, as we understand quite recently, we actually had a very good Fort Britain meeting in there, you know, good times to have oil, but now it's under different hands, owned by people with apparently something of a different agenda.
Anne-Marie was there, you spoke, it was a very good meeting.
Yep.
And this building is now used as a hub to store food to give to these bogus migrants.
It's very sad because, you know, as you say, it's a very worthy enterprise which has now been somewhat sullied by this. Okay, now just behind me here is the old Wolfram Abbey Town Hall, which is acting as a local hub for distribution of food to local people who are in need, poor people. Now, as a Wolfram Abbey councillor, district councillor for Paternoster Ward, this is ordinarily something I'll be very happy and proud to support. Unfortunately, the bad news though is much of this food intended for our own poor and needy here in Wolfram Abbey, including my own constituents in Paternoster, in some cases, is being redistributed to a hotel in Epping, which is currently being used to house asylum seekers stroke illegal immigrants. People get fed anyway, three meals a day anyway, and they should be in the country in the first place. And this is just not right.
Normally, it would be a very supportable scheme.
Absolutely.
It's being undermined, isn't it?
It is. It's been sullied. Okay, we're here now in Paternoster Ward that I represent on the Epping Forest District Council. Now, there are pockets of deprivation in this ward, and I know for a fact I've met certain people, you know, in the ward that would certainly appreciate themselves some of the free food that is currently being diverted to these asylum seekers being put up in the hotel in Epping.
There is a solution to these problems that we've been looking at, and that is to stand in your local communities for election to the local council and get elected for Fort Britain, as Julian did recently.
Yeah, and if I can do it, you can do it too. And the solution to the things that we've been talking about today is to stop voting for the politicians who are responsible for it and choose a better alternative instead.
Thank you. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe.